Jake Hackert, master pipe carver, handcrafter of Hackert pipes. And this is his shop here in Lancaster. Nice, looks like he's got everything he needs.
All close at hand.
To make these beautiful pipes. And it looks like he's been busy.
This is a big lathe because I also used to make canes when I had the time.
Really?
I have one here that I started.
I know.
Probably about a year and a half ago. That's as far as I got with it. I didn't even get to turn it.
You ever make any shillelaghs?
Oh, that's no. Fancy dancing.
What's he got in there? Two black trucks.
Yeah, it's one thing. Oh, yeah, actually, those are the ones. Oh, he's got that huge tray.
Dodge Ram. Oh, that's for the big Dodge Ram. You see the chick with the
big hair?
There we have it. There's a little tiny trace. But
it'll do the job. Thank you, Jake.
Now, this is just basically a wood lathe. You got it. Adjust the speed accordingly because one of the chucks is off of it to hold the pipe because the shank area would stick out too far, so it's off balance. So you got to adjust your speed to hit the right speed where it don't vibrate.
Yeah, for sure.
My pipes are made. They're made with hand tools.
Just a good old gouge chisel.
A lot of pipe makers use a machinist lathe where you just set it up. You can just run straight here. Yeah. You can dig in. You can go crooked.
That's right.
Yeah, you can do. You got a little bit more.
I feel my pipes come about as close to being handmade as you got most people do. Now I'm going to show you as a tenon turning tool. This is how the stems come. I don't know if you ever seen how stems come. Vulcanite molded stems. They have an edge. A seam like you got to clean all this up. This is not. A lot of people are under the conception that you take them and they can buy a stem and just put it right on the pipe.
Yeah.
It don't work that way. Mm. This has to be cut to fit the shank. This would be the tenon. The part it slides into is the mortise. So they have to be cut and fit together. I could sell somebody a stem, but most of my mortises I drilled a 5/16. But if I sold someone a stem that's turning my tool to 5/16, it ain't gonna be a perfect fit. That has to be fit with a file, a little sand, a little, and fit that way. Then you would take this stem, there's a special drill bit. It's just a couple thousandths over 1/8 of an inch. You have to drill that excess out of there. The hole goes the whole way through. But this is not the finished hole.
You're gonna bore it out.
So when that's drilled out, to fit the pin, this is a tenon turning tool. This goes in my drill press. This is adjustable, this cutter. That's a carbide cutter. And this one I have set to 5/16. Normally, I have one that I just use for repair work that I have to adjust it each time. This is set to 5/16, I have one set to 3/8. But they're actually a little oversized because the final adjustment's done with a file and sandpaper. But anyway, you put a piece of rubber in the vise. Well, I'll cut one. And a turning tool here.
I don't know what it is. I don't know.
Tapping into some Jake Hackert power over here to record this right now. This is some supernatural stuff going on right here.
You actually got to saw a little bit off of that. Because that ends up being 5/8 inch long.
How long you been making pipes, Jake?
Probably about 18 years now. But it didn't start out that sales were like they are now.
Do you got any?
I started out, the first pipes I put in a tobacco shop was DeMoose Tobacco Shop in Lancaster, and I actually had to put them there and consign them.
Are you selling pipes down there at the other tobacco?
I sell at DeMoose Tobacco Shop, the Tinder Box at Chelsea Square, Old World Tobacco out in the Lincoln Highway East, and Seven Valleys Custom Blends, which is over on 462. And then we cut the tank.
Is it picked up?
And the stink you smell is the sulfur, vulcanized high sulfur.
This is a good shot.
This is gold.
See how it's coming?
Now I'm up front, son.
That's how a 10-inch cut. Then there's one other step. A lot of your factory pipes really don't do it, but I believe it improves the airflow in the pipe. You have to put a chamfer
in. Oh yeah. Oh, that little
see, rather than hit a shoulder, Your air flows and is guided right into
right.
it.
Taper it.
Mm-hmm. And I use a little bit larger a draft hold than a lot of pipe makers.
That's noticeable. I remember when we bought ours, we called back and told you that it's a noticeable difference.
Right? I don't like a pipe that you have to get anything out of it. I like something that's got a little flow. If a piece of tobacco gets through it, so be it.
Yeah.
So then, what I would do is drill an 1/8-inch hole in here. I usually go between horizontal and vertical, about 45 degrees, to put my silver dot, which is a nickel silver rod. This is just a little piece of it that's left. But once that hole's drilled, I put the rod in there, mark it, and cut it off. Then that has to be filed and worked down smooth with the stem. They're about a foot long when I buy the rods. Now, here, this is basically a pipe that's laid out. What you have to do is lay out your draft hole, your tobacco chamber hole. You take these centers got to stay true, or your draft hole will get off in the bottom of your pipe. A little bit's acceptable, but
big pipe, right?
Yes, please. Thank you, sir.
That would be your pipe.
Thank you very much. Appreciate it.
Awesome. I'm not sure, Matthew. I think it's
mess. Awesome.
Oh, wow. The other one, I'm not sure who this was.
Right here. You can see mine from here.
That's me right here.
Oh my. Oh man, what?
Oh wow, look at this.
Oh man.
YouTube 2010.
Dang.
I don't know what you think of that, but
that's awesome.
That's not sandblast. That's rusticated.
No,
it's
rusticated. This,
that is sick right there. That's what I'm talking about.
How?
Because
I even told him, I was like, that's gotta be, he had the sandblast.
I have a sandblast, but it's not really
I thought that one was sandblast.
Yeah, because see how tight that is on there.
That's what I told Salam, that some of my really fine sandblast
are next
rustication.
I love that.
Thank you, Jake.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah,
thanks a lot.
Yeah. I'm really happy.
Oh, yeah.
So
I like them both ways, but I don't have one like this.
That's beautiful right here.
Yeah, I like the shape of that one.
That's a nice poker for sure.
Hell yeah.
Well, that's a hefty one.
That's for sure.
See, I laid myself towards a little bit bigger pipe.
Did you load that thing up with Jeff?
That's, man, I can play cards for a while with that one.
Back
and
forth.
For sure.
Wraps.
Wow, look at that.
Got two of them deuced up.
They're nice.
Yes, they are.
You got the LMS?
Yep.
Yeah.
This is
the cool. LMS.
Hard guy, right?
That's where it's at.
It don't matter how good
equipment PGR special, baby.
Oh, yeah.
No, love it. Exactly.
There's people that make flintlock rifles.
OMS special right here.
Practically make them sit in the living room.
Sweet. Oh, yeah.
That's right.
As opposed to somebody that has milling machines and all kinds of stuff, if they don't want to do it.
That's right. Doesn't matter.
A longer version of it. With the squirrels.
Custom building.
Yeah. That was Tracy Mincher. You ever see a cigar pipe?
Oh, I seen one of those,
yeah. Yeah, it screws apart here. And you put your tobacco in there. You can smoke this in pretty high wind.
Interesting. Never saw one of those before.
I have a rough finish one, a smooth finish one. This pipe here, that's water buffalo horn.
You make that one?
But the reason they use this is because the water buffalo horn's that unstable. It expands and contracts so much, it would either be real loose or real tight. Hmm. So there can be, you can control the tightness of it.
That's a Hackert there, I tell.
There's quite a few of them out there that I do smoke. That's all absorbable. Almost all meerschaum pipes, except this is an unusual pipe that you probably have never seen. This is Bakelite.
Oh,
nice.
It's different.
Yeah, look at that stair. It's
a bit.
That's cool looking. Where'd you get that one?
Some woman contacted me. The Moose gave her my name. Her husband had a stroke when he was like 80, and he couldn't smoke anymore. And she wanted to know if I would buy his pipe collection. Well, he only had a couple of pipes that I bought. And that's how I come by that.
That's cool.